Hello everyone, I think all are safe and stay home. Now today I am discuss about the topic of electric traction. This presentation outline the following subtopics: introduction, advantages of electric traction, system of electric traction, power supply for electric traction system, comparison between AC and DC traction system, and substation equipments. Now, introduction. A driving force that causes propulsion of a vehicle is called traction system. A traction system which uses electrical power for propulsion of vehicle is called electric traction. Now, electric traction means propulsion or driving of vehicle by use of electricity is called electric traction. Now the two types of traction systems, electric traction system and non-electric traction system. Now the following examples of electric traction systems are tramways, trolley buses and railways. Now following examples of non-electric traction systems are steam engine drive and IC engine drive, etc. Non-electric traction systems which do not involve the use of electricity. And the characteristics of a good traction systems are high starting torque, high rapid acceleration, able to run any route, and minimum tear and wear on a track. Now, advantages of electric traction system over non-electric traction system. Why we prefer electric traction systems? Because it is the clean and pollution free traction systems, because it is environmentally helpful. There is no flue gases, no ash, etc. It can be used in underground railways and it requires less maintenance. Electric traction system starting torque is high, its speed control is simple, electric braking is simple and efficient, and the regenerative braking is more efficient, and the last, rapid acceleration and retardation means speed increasing or decreasing quickly according to our needs. System of electric tractions. The track electrification refers to the type of source supply systems that is used while powering the electric locomotive systems. It can be AC or DC or composite systems. Now the first is DC system. In this system, electric motors are operate on DC supply. In DC systems, only one conductor or rail is required to supply power to the locomotive, while track are used as return conductor. So only one conductors are used, hence the copper losses are reduced. In DC traction systems, consumes less energy. The equipment in DC traction is less costly and lighter. In DC traction systems, no communication interference. Now in AC traction systems, first is single phase AC traction system. In this traction system, AC series motors are used to produce the propulsion of vehicle. In this AC systems, the AC voltage is from 15 kV to 25 kV at a frequency of 25 Hz. The single phase supply is fed to the locomotive unit via single overhead line, while track provides the return path. In single phase traction systems, also only one conductor is used, and hence the copper losses are also reduced. Three phase AC traction system. In this traction systems, three phase induction motors are used for the propulsion of vehicle. In this system, two overhead line for two phases, while track from third phase. This system normally works on 3.3 kilovolt, which is stepped down from high voltage transmission line such as 132 kV or 110 kV, etc. Three-phase induction motors has following characteristics such as simple and robust constructions, self-starting, high efficiency, regenerative braking, etc. Now the composite traction systems. Composite systems means combining both the advantages of AC and DC traction system. In these systems, the overhead line carries single phase 25 kV 50 Hz supply, which is then stepped down to a desired range using a step down transformer located in the locomotive unit. This single phase supply is then converted into DC using rectifier and then applied to the DC series motor. Advantages of these systems are high starting efficiency, lower cost of installations. Now the next topic is comparison between AC and DC traction systems. Now the different systems. AC system is preferred for mainline railway services such as due to higher voltages, spacing of substations can be large of about 40 to 50 kilometers. Similarly, DC system is suitable for suburban line railway services where the distance between substation is less about 5 to 6 kilometers. In AC systems, energy consumption is more for same output, but in DC system, energy consumption is less. In AC system, the weight of AC locomotive is more and has a high maintenance cost, while in DC system, the weight of a DC locomotive is less and requires less maintenance. In AC system, as higher voltages, so the cost of conductor is reduced because the cost of conductor is inversely proportional to the voltages. Now, in DC system, cost of overhead conductor is more as operating voltages are low. In AC system, capital, maintaining and running cost of substation is less. In DC system, capital investment on substation is more due to converting equipment. In AC systems, it causes interference in the communication line, and in DC system, no communication interferences. Now, substation equipments. Now the following of the substation equipments are necessary in substation. First is traction transformer. Traction transformers are used for step down the voltages for the locomotives. They have input voltage of 220 kV or 166 kV or 132 kV or 110 kV, which is stepped down to 25 kV. Next, lightning arrestor. It protects the substation equipments from transient high voltages and also limit the flow of current. The lightning arrestor is connected between line and earth. The lightning arrestors divert the current of surges to the earth and hence protect the insulation and conductor of the system from damage. Instrument transformers. It just name is indicates that instrument transformer is used to reduce high voltages and current to a safe value. It is also used for actuating the AC type protective relay by supplying the current and voltages by current and potential transformers. The instrument transformers are divided into two types, current transformer and potential transformer. The current transformers are used to reduce the current value and the potential transformer are used to reduce the voltages. Isolator. It is a type of switch which is employed only for isolating the circuit when the current has only been interrupted. The isolator is disconnected switch operates under no load conditions. Next, circuit breaker. Circuit breaker. The circuit breaker is a type of electrical switches which is used for opening or closing of electrical circuits whenever faults occur in the systems. Different types of circuit breakers are such as SF6, vacuum circuit breakers, oil blast circuit breakers, air blast circuit breakers, etc. Indicators and metering instruments are major role of substations, ammeter, voltmeter, wattmeter, energy meter, power factor meters. All the measuring instruments are installed in substation to control and maintain a watch over the current flowing through the circuit and over the power load. Protective relay. Relay is a sensing device which senses the fault and sends a tripping signal to the circuit breakers for disconnect the faulting sections from healthy station system. Different types of protective relays such as over current relay, over voltages, under voltage, frequency, under frequency, over frequencies relays, etc. Insulator. Insulator is used to insulate the busbar systems or to healthy system. This is a layout diagram of traction substation. Thank you.